Hi there, in this video I'm going to talk about user ID within MathTomo Analytics. The idea of this video came when I received on the same day twice the same demand dealing with the user ID. So here typically in the form one is asking how to set the user ID if you are using MathTomo Tag Manager, so that's more what I'm going to talk about. So user ID, to sum it up, it's a feature in order to match a given individual according to the different devices or visits or times that he went on the website, and which are linked together thanks to a given ID, which is mostly given when once get connected. For this I'm going to use a WordPress website, even though MathTomo is already providing a plugin which already have the user ID set on. In my case, I'm gonna show how you can get it from scratch. So in order to implement the user ID, what you need to have is one way to call your database in order to grab the one given identifier. So for WordPress, by chance, a lot of people wrote documentation, and that's how you can get it within WordPress. It's by, in fact, calling different functions, and in my case I decided to extract one which is the user login that I will use as the user ID. So to say, this is how I made it. So in fact here I have my PHP function, which is in fact grabbing the current user ID, and so it's I'm calling wget-current-user, and then once I grab this information I'm just asking to get the login, and then once I'm getting those once I'm getting this variable, which is the current user ID, then I'm calling the current user ID within a data layer variable that I can grab afterward. So to say, when I do something like this, and when I look through my website, such as I'm doing right now, I will see that in fact the UID, this given variable that I just named like this, is going to take the value root. And of course, if I log on my my website again, so that's localhost and WP, that's the one. So if I connect to this given website, so WP admin, and that I'm using this given password, the one that you can see over here, and I'm accessing to the website, I will see that within the source code I'm getting the UID equal John. So now I need to find out a way in order to call this given login. So for this, I'm gonna go within MathTomo Tag Manager over here. I'm gonna create a data layer variable, which is gonna be called UID, but I could have called it the way I want. So I'm just gonna go over here, I'm gonna go to data layer, I'm just gonna give it the name over here, which is UID, which is the one that I added. And before publishing, in fact, what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna modify this given variable over here, the one that you have here, and I'm gonna call the user ID over here, and the user ID is gonna be the UID. So here it means that by just adding this given variable within this field, it's gonna add above the track page view the feature user ID with the variable which would have been grabbed. So here I should be alright. So if I go back now on my website, so if I refresh this page, it's not going to be perfect here. Oh, that's going to be perfect because they have root, so it's going to be alright. So here nothing changed in the code because everything has been loaded thanks to the container. And if I look at my data, so tests is the environment of today. If I look over here, we get the visit log with the root information. Now if I move back to my previous screen, which was probably this one, if I refresh this page, so this one is where you have John as an identifier, and that I'm moving back over here, that I refresh the page, I will get John. Here I'm not getting John, and I think that's probably because there's a conflict in term of user, because this one, as you can see, it's definitely matching with one with the same configuration as I have elsewhere. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to do exactly the same thing, but I'm just going to connect through Chromium, and like this, it will be an independent browser, and it should be. And it should be right. So let's go for it. So localhost WP. Okay, that's my WordPress. And so I'm just gonna connect to it once more. So WP login. Okay.php. And just connect to it. So apps and visit the website. So now John is visiting the website, that's what we can see here. And if I'm lucky enough for this demo, we should get in fact the UID filled in with John, and that's it. So I succeed in implementing the user ID. The only drawback of the technique that I show you here is that it's not showing you the case in which I'm not connected at all, and if I'm not connected at all, well, the value of the user ID is going to be equal to zero, and then it means high chances it's going to create a user ID which equal zero, which means that you need to remove this this parts out. So that's probably what I'm going to try to do over here. I'm going to just connect back to localhost WordPress like this. And unfortunately, I think that in my case, gonna still consider that this is the root user. Whereas actually, in this case, it should be equal to zero in terms of user ID. So okay, I'm not getting it probably because it's recorded over here. But just to let you know that in fact, it's gonna work if in WordPress you call the database and you just extract the identifier. Then you are using this identifier as the value for your variable within the data layer, and then within the container you are adding the data layer variable in order to have the value working fine, and that's everything you needed to know in order to integrate user ID within Matomo Analytics. Thanks for watching.